Everyone, welcome to another episode of the show I Have Notes, where a bunch of people from Rishi's animation department or otherwise come together to talk about anything animation, creative, and spooky ghosts. I am the gasp of ghosts. I am your host today, Issa Badiola, and with me is my co-host.
I'm back. You can't get rid of me.
Spooky.
Oh, back from the grave. By popular demand.
Carrie Shawcross, everybody. Hello. How are you doing? I've missed you all. I especially missed a guest we've had on before, Cole Galleon.
That's right. It's me, Cole, the Blood Boy Galleon, back at it again.
That's how we know him.
Yep.
That's how
CBBG, as they call me on the in the streets and the sheets.
All right. And okay, now he's off the show, and we've also got.
Thanks for having
Chad
me.
James.
Chad, how's it going?
Hi, Chad.
I definitely
James.
Didn't forget your last name for like a split second.
Even though you missed Cole the most, I'm still happy to be here. I miss you, Carrie. I miss getting to play D&D with you every week. All right.
I know. I honestly, I was just using that as a way to signal that I was going to go to Cole first. Because like someone who's been here before. My cat is sitting off camera, by the way.
It's been forever since we've been on a show.
Yeah, I know. The last show we were on was Death Battle Cast, and that was that was one of the best episodes of Death Battle Cast.
Absolutely. That was the last thing we were on together as well, Chad.
That's
Death Battle Cast.
That wasn't the last thing we were on together, Chad.
All right, hold on. So the last thing I was on with Issa was that I Have Notes, I think.
Was it backwards compatible?
Was it backwards compatible?
Was it backwards compatible? Chad, what do you think?
Shows that you could watch right now on roosterteeth.com with your first membership. So stay subscribed or sign up for a free trial.
Chad's Don't give me that shit. Chad, tell me now, what was the last thing that Cole and Issa were on together? Go.
It was, I believe Issa, and it was backwards compatible.
All right. Wrong. It was... I have Death Notes.
Hold on. TM. Trademark.
TM, trademark.
That's the crossover.
Yeah. I have Death Notes.
That's really good. I like that one,
10-year later Death Note podcast.
When did Death Note come out?
Yeah, but you're going to go through cast members really fast.
Yeah. Oh, I see. Oh, that's the that is a really good trademark. That's a really good podcast idea, actually.
Yeah, I have Death Notes. That's because it's spooky.
Right.
Oh, that should have been the Halloween ones.
Ooh. Or.
Oh, you still have Halloween week. You still have Halloween week.
Or is that like a spin-off of Good Morning from Hell?
It's the crossover.
Have they had Light Yagami show up in Good Morning from Hell?
Have they had William Dafoe?
Available now wherever you consume your podcast.
Or Ryu?
I think they need to have William Dafoe on
Or
you watch it on your Ryuku.
Yeah.
Or,
here, I can be light.
Cool.
No, that's not light. You idiot. That's L. That's L. What are you doing?
No,
sit like
how...
light. Put a camera in your chips.
No, you don't. No, this is how light sits now.
Oh my God, Carrie. I'm a.
No. I have an OC. In I Have Death Notes, this is how light sits.
I almost spit my drink out in the I Have an OC.
My name is K.
My name is Kay.
Why did they name the two characters L and Light?
It's very confusing.
There are 26 distinct letters in the alphabet. Men in Black figured it out. Why can't they?
But in the Men in Black, that meant there could only be 26 characters.
I'm trying to figure out
how did they deal with that?
I'm trying to figure out.
I wrote Death Note Carry. All right.
How did I die?
Well, it'll be a heart attack because I didn't write anything.
Oh, that's true. You could have written like Elvis Presley.
Hold on. Time out.
No, he falls out of his chair impersonating the wrong character and dies.
Yeah. No, well, I try and sit light. Like this on the toilet and I pull an Elvis Presley and I die in the toilet.
Oh. You die from light. There we go. I fixed it.
Oh.
Thank you, Cole.
Hey, I can do that. Here, I can do that. Hang on. Here we go.
Do
ready?
You have an actual? Wait, I'm ready. Do it, Kerry.
I'm dying from light.
Are you just cranking your...
Oh, it's so bright.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's so bright.
It's getting me, too.
If you're watching the audio-only version of this podcast, I turned the brightness on my light very high.
Go to about 6 minutes in, and you'll see us both die from extreme light.
Yeah, it was very bright.
Oh, you can see Cole's room now.
Yeah, I was going to say, Cole, you weren't even on in frame when that happened. So.
Yeah.
I know.
Oh, it's so spooky.
So spooky.
The spookiest times.
Hey, should I go cool light or warm light? What's better? Oh, that's better. Put some color on my face. Okay, cool. Thanks. I've been gone for 2 weeks.
This is part of the creative process.
Issa, hey, Cole and Chad, give me a sec. Issa, how'd the last shows go? Did anybody fuck it up?
No, it was pretty okay. This is
great.
Pretty par for course. We had great. Some strong opinions about Disney Plus.
I mean, that cheese. Happened when I was around too. So I heard there's some cheese talk.
Yes, we had a surprise fifth member last week, and there
we
is
always
some...
have a fifth member.
Oh yeah, you're right. You're right.
Stash Chan.
Yes, you're correct.
How does Stash Chan feel about cheese? Okay, Cole, Chad, you can come back now.
Oh, Stash Chan loves cheese, Gary. He told me about it.
Thank you.
I saw a bunch of just yellow mess in his glorious stash, and I was like, what the heck is that?
No, he's actually a mustard boy.
And it was a little bit of both. It was nacho cheese from Taco Bell that he put a bunch of mustard in.
Gotcha. Because that hasn't been canceled at Taco Bell yet.
Yeah.
No.
We'll see. If they get rid of the Baja Blast,
we're all dead. That was a fake article. That was fake news, Carrie. That was fake news. That was fake news. That was a fake article.
It's not. Hey, whoever did that,
it's not funny.
There's enough bad in this year.
It's not fucking funny. 2020 is taking everything from me. And if it takes the Baja Blast, I cannot be responsible for what I will do. And by that, I mean I will go to the grocery store and get a 2 liter of Mountain Dew and Blue Powerade and mix them.
Oh.
Is that what it is?
Probably. I think
that's
so.
What Chris Kokinos has done the math and tried to figure it out.
It makes a lot of sense.
So,
do you have a KFC cup?
Cole's going to explain.
Yes,
tried. Senior Colonel.
Senior Colonel, Issa's boyfriend, the Colonel. I tried the sweet lightning flavor of Mountain Dew from KFC because each PepsiCo establishment apparently has their own flavor of Mountain Dew.
Really?
And I guess this is an offshoot. We're only plugging other shows today, I guess. So this is your personal face jam coming at you.
Oh, cool.
It was bad.
Oh. Y'all should really watch Face Jam, by the way, because they're not getting a lot of views. So if you don't watch it, no one will.
I blame Eric Bardot personally.
Yeah, that guy doesn't know how to promote anything.
No.
Shame.
Especially Furby.
Yeah.
How is it?
It's 2 out of 10. It's
ooh,
bad.
Wow.
Man,
it tastes like
rough.
Orange soda, but like
that's
if
good.
You imagine
but
the
bad.
Taste of orange soda and add purple.
Okay.
Now I'm conflicted like because soda. I like orange soda and I like
purple.
The purple
like
flavor. I'm specifically saying purple and not grape.
Hold on.
Yes, yeah.
No, but here's the thing. Is it like delicious, like sweet purple, or is it like Dime-A-Tap medicine purple? Because those are very different.
I will anything purple for me personally. I liked Dime-A-Tap growing up. I looked forward to getting sick. Because I get my tap fix.
It tastes like imagine a tangerine soda, but it's always flat.
Ugh.
Mm.
Dude, April bought me a soda machine the other day.
Ooh. Wow.
Like,
hey,
whoa.
We'll like reduce our like bottle footprint and whatever. And I was like, that's great.
Quick clarity question.
We bought the cheap ass one.
Are we talking about a vending machine or are we talking
about
aerator?
Like a carbonator aerator
okay.
thing, right?
Okay, you know? Okay.
Now they're on the same page. You're right, because that would have been ridiculous.
I was like, whoa, damn. Okay.
So you bought a cheap one.
Yeah, so we bought the cheap one. Because, you know, a lot of times it's just like you pay for like a name brand or whatever. But like, we should have shelled out. And so I'm going to return it because this thing, first of all, it's like goddamn near impossible to get the bottle out once it starts its shit. And like, you got to like pull pieces out of it and like, it's got to be on the edge of a counter, but it doesn't weigh that much. And it's like, it
sucks. Wow.
But anyway, I was all excited. And I was like, okay, let me do this. I'm like, I got the like CO2 cartridge in there, get the bottle in with the water at the right line. And I'm like, okay, here we go. And like, I made sure it was sealed. And the first thing I did was like, all right, and go. And it just fucking blasted me with like a tidal wave of water all over the kitchen. I've used it about 8 times, and probably 7 of those 8 times, like, water is blasting everywhere in the fucking kitchen. And
oh,
I'm just
wow.
I'm sending it back. I'm going to buy a fancy
one. Before you send it back, you got to try every liquid you can find.
I was going to say, do milk.
Do milk. That's what I was going to say.
Do milk.
Well, so here's the other thing about this one. Because I started looking it up. And I found the other ones. It's like, oh, this one clearly screws into its thing or whatever. And it's not going to blast me in the face and all over the kitchen. And it was like, you can do any liquid. And there are like comments that are just like, I like make my wine sparkle. Like, I sparkle my wine with this shit. And I'm like, oh, you can do anything. And the one I have, it's just like, don't put fucking anything in this bitch except for water.
Oh my God.
Like, anything. Like, you add your flavors later, but flavors don't go in to the machine.
Is it like LaCroix branded?
It has to be tap water. You can't even put that Ozarka. Get Ozarka out of here. Mineral water? No way.
If this has a pH balance above 7, it will destroy your house.
It was kind of scary, though, because I was like reading this thing. It's like, okay, so like, you know, use this properly, or like it could result in serious harm. Because it does have a CO2 cartridge that's like this fucking big.
Oh my
gosh. So I was like, I guess if you don't do it right, that could blow up.
That could blow up, yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah.
Mm. Still do milk, though.
Yeah.
But listen, I'm going to return it. I'm going to get the good one.
And then you'll do milk.
Then you'll do milk.
No, do milk on the one you're going to send
foam.
Back. Yeah, it's going to foam in your new one, and you're going to get...
Do milk on the old one, and it'll be like, I don't know why it doesn't
work. And then return it to Amazon.
Yeah. Yes. If not, you're going to get milk in your Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
You don't want milky cola.
That sounds like a root beer float.
Oh, shit.
What if I just don't do milk? What if I don't carbonate
Well,
milk?
That's not an option.
That's stupid.
Yeah.
let's look this up.
Oh, Chad's gonna look it up.
Can you carbonate milk?
Yes. Speaking of
Sorry,
that,
real
you
quick,
know what?
The first thing. Carbonated milk is milk that has been carbonated and sold for human consumption.
Oh,
who fucking
shit.
Wrote that?
Oh.
Oh no.
As opposed
My
to
business of carbonated milk for cats is ruined.
Oh, they would be so cute, though. They might get little, like, hiccups.
Burps. Slip.
Little burp.
Oh, my gosh.
Nice. Good one, guys. I'm appreciating this.
So,
looks like it is a thing. I'm just saying. If there's a different... No. If there's a Google textbook definition.
I'm
isn't
just
that what
saying.
Yoo-hoo is? Isn't that what Yoo-hoo is? Isn't it just like carbonated,
is it carbonated
chocolate
milk?
Oh, Yoo-hoo.
No,
no, it's chocolate milk.
Yoo-hoo's not. Yeah, it's just chocolate milk.
It's just chalky milky.
Chalky milky.
Chalky milky, yeah. But it's something weird about it.
I think
you're
it is
wrong.
One of those chocolate milks that doesn't have
is
to be
it,
refrigerated.
Ooh, something's not
oh, yeah.
About
you're
you
not
think
wrong.
It is.
You're not wrong.
I went and Googled, is Yoo-hoo carbonated? Answers, nope. Never was carbonated. Never will be.
Yeah. It's oh, okay. Google. Yeah. Sam is letting us know it's chocolate drink.
Yeah,
it's not milk.
That's important.
Thank you. I knew something was up with it.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Sam.
Yeah.
Ain't no milk, Sam.
Important distinction.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Sam.
Not.
Well, welcome, Chad. This
yeah,
for...
thanks. This is a fun show already.
Hell yeah. It's just downhill from here.
I know, yes. Yeah. We just aspire for this kind of chaos. Honestly, I welcome it.
Yeah, I need some chaos in my week.
Yeah. Oh, and here he is, Chad. The chaos machine.
Chad, bring the chaos.
As they call me.
Go.
Also, what is it? You? On the streets and in the sheets call? Is that what you
Yeah,
you're
on the streets and in on the sheets as well.
What if what? I mean, you don't want to get them dirty. Yeah.
Wouldn't you still?
That's why you
well,
bring the blood in the streets and on the sheets.
And sometimes you take the sheets out and you take them to the streets.
And then you got blood
and
on the sheets
hide
in the streets.
Hide them real good.
Yeah. With the body. And the milk.
Yeah,
the carbonated
the milk, body.
Milk.
The milk body.
Carbonated milk sounds like definitely something a serial killer would drink.
And
oh,
like a
sure.
band.
It yeah.
Like a shitty high school punk
we
band.
We are carbonated milk.
Can that
this
be your guys' band
called
name?
Curdled.
Yeah. Curdled.
It could be.
I can see you guys making a band
we're,
called carbonated
we're
milk.
Called
I'm gonna
lactose intolerant.
On carbonated milk.
No, we'd be lactose tolerant.
Lactose tolerant.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Milk, please. And that'd be what we say whenever we come out. We yell at our fans. We go, milk, please.
Milk, please.
And then the fans would throw carbonated milk at us.
Can this be your VTuber personalities?
Please.
Oh, I wish.
I need a. I bought the one on Steam, Face Rig.
Oh,
yeah.
I haven't set it up.
Oh, nice.
Okay, cool.
It's happening.
Before
are you, Carrie? Are you falling in? Are you falling in the hole?
The VTuber hole.
Oh, we'll see, man. We stuck. I'm not even trying to swim out anymore.
Yeah.
We simp hard in this house.
Nice. Oh my god. So before we started recording, Chad, actually, you brought up something that is happening. Extra Life. Can you, Chad, tell us about what we're planning to do for Extra Life this year?
Sure. So we've announced a little bit. But basically we're going to do the community stream on November 8th, I believe is the right date. 1 week before the 14th. So whatever that is, I think it's the 8th. Could be the 7th. It looks like it's probably the 7th.
I think it might be the 7th.
No, but I was so close.
Anyway, so I'm sorry. I slacked Noelle. I know I'm supposed to be talking about this, but I slacked Noelle and I said, I know how you feel about cheese, but what are your thoughts on carbonated milk? And his response is all caps. What the fuck? I couldn't resist.
That's really good. That's really good.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
Anyway, back to the really important cause that you guys all help raise money for sick children.
Yeah, carbonated milk.
The community stream will be kicking off Extra Life Week. All week long, RTTV will be brought to you by Extra Life. You'll be able to do donations, buy merchandise all throughout that week leading up to the 14th, which then we will have a 12-hour marathon where we hope to have Jack, Katie, myself, and potentially Chelsea in studio. We'll be like kicking to some like at-home segments and maybe some other fun stuff. But we're turning into a whole event because 24 hours, like, we will happily do again when it's the normal times. but we felt 12 was probably good for.
I obviously was not a part of any of these decisions. I'm just here. I definitely feel like that 24 hours was doable because we were together.
And could
champion each other. If I start drinking at 2 a.m. here, I'm out by 3.
Also, I think, logistically, with having to switch the broadcast people out, like making sure they're not being overworked, it just makes sense to do like a 12-hour from home.
I think it'd be great. I'm really excited.
So, you know, we'll see. So technically, it'll be all like the same program you guys are used to on RTTV. But, you know, if some people want to go the extra mile and like, you know, do some sort of donation incentivizing tie-in, some fun wacky thing for the stream, they can
drinking
carbonated milk. Let's see if we can get Noelle to drink that or eat some cheese.
Let's carbonate some cheese.
Goo queso. You can melt some cheese and carbonate it.
Yeah,
I thought it was so funny that you guys talked about that last week because like I've had that conversation with him. I can't even tell you for how long.
Oh my god.
But yeah, all of our merchandise this year, most of our merchandise, sorry, will be print on demand. So we won't run into the scenario like last year where we were like, hey, guess what? The hoodies are all gone.
Nice. Nice.
Yeah, that went real quick. So
we should probably
we also have some kind of exclusive merch drops planned. We got a lot of really fun stuff and all in the name of, you know, a good cause. So this year specifically, our theme is courage because part of the thing that we're doing with Dell Children's is we're raising money to help build this new center as part of Dell Children's Here campaign, which is all centered around not having to outsource as many patients because it's like really, really, really difficult on families. Imagine like already like, you know, your kid is sick with some, you know, terrible thing that they have to go through. And then on top of that, being like, oh, you know, we don't specialize in what this particular child needs. So you're gonna have to go to Houston. You know, something like that. And that's super hard. Think about like, you know, you're working, but now you have to be in Houston. You have to get a hotel. Like you might be there for, you know, days, weeks, months. So they're basically the whole thing has been a long plan where they like built this school because a lot of like, you know, top like doctors, they want to not only be able to, you know, perform and help people, but they want to be able to pass on their skills and their knowledge and teach. So it started with that. So now they've got some really great experts in these fields. And the next part was building them a facility. So this facility specifically focusing on the three largest areas of where they would have to outsource patients, which is cardiology, neurology, and hematology oncology. And so last year our theme was the heart. And this building's gonna be built in 3 years, so it was kind of perfect that there's three things. We're working with them for 3 years on this thing, and so we get to hit these three different themes for Extra Life. So last year was the heart. This year it's hematology oncology, but we chose to go with courage because it takes obviously a lot of courage to battle cancer. And yeah, next year will be neurology. So that's kind of our theme this year. And we know it's crazy time in the world for a bunch of people, and a lot of people's financial states have changed. And it's been really interesting because I've seen some people be like, this is great. Like, because I'm stuck at home and still employed, like, I'm saving so much money and like, I'm going to donate. And it's like, whoa, that's really cool. But of course, there's other people that it's like, you know, this has really affected their employment and they may not have the money to donate this year. So like, we're just all in this together, and the goal is let's just do something good in 2020.
Something good has to happen this year.
Yeah.
Yes, that is the theme. Exactly.
Don't do that to me, Carrie. We can do it. We can do it. We can do the good thing. We can do the, okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah.
Yeah.
Take it upon ourselves.
Something good.
Nothing good's going to happen to us. We have to go out and do something.
We have to make it happen. And hey, maybe Chad, that was all great, and that was really inspiring. In case that doesn't work on you, if we don't get enough money, we'll make kids drink carbonated milk.
And that's an I Have Notes guarantee.
That's a Cole Galleon personal guarantee.
Cole Blood Boy Galleon guarantee.
CBBG.
You don't want to know what you have to drink if you don't drink the carbonated milk.
We're not gonna make anybody drink anything. It's gonna be. I think it'll. I think it'll be a great event, and I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, me too. I'm like slightly worried I'm gonna get punished even more than normal.
Oh,
you'll be there in person.
I would love that. You're just such an easy volunteer, Chad.
Yeah, well,
a willing volunteer
for the kids, right?
Exactly.
Yeah,
always for the kids.
But see, it's that volunteer is a strong word in some cases. But then the problem is now there's this reputation that's developed where that's it's true. Just like, oh, Chad'll do it. Hence the mustard incident, Issa.
Oh.
The mustard incident?
This is like
stares.
The last when Anim comes on at the end of Extra Life, I'm done. Like it's just like we're at the end. In my mind, we have done it. Like we're good. And I just go chill on that back. Chris Damaris is usually sleeping somewhere next to me.
Yeah,
like, or sometimes there's a dog. It's like, but I'm just like, okay.
Sometimes it's Chris in a dog costume.
You're petting something. It's either Chris or a dog.
Exactly. Jack and Katie are back. They're driving it. And we've got all of animation and Maggie and you guys and everybody's doing their thing. And I'm like, great. This is like coasting from here. They're going to finish their segment. Matt's going to come on and sing a song. And like, then we're all going to cry because we did really cool things and the community's amazing. But I can just sit here. And then so I don't even know how it came up, but I just remember being vaguely aware of what was going on. Mm. And some challenge was like somebody had to write their name in mustard on someone's back.
Oh, yes.
And I just remember like we got to that and no one was like, I'll do it. And then I just remember people searching around and I was like,
Chad.
Chris, wake up. Chris, wake up, they need you for something.
And then they're just like, Chad'll do it. And I'm just like, ah. And then Issa wrote her name on my back with
her
tongue
and
mustard.
Did anybody then have to lick it off?
I mean, that's... No. I mean, like, they put mustard all over my back, and then she licked her name into it.
You just reminded me that this happened, and I, like, blacked it out.
Carrie, he's with a bunch of freaks, man.
Yeah, I thought Too Spooky was crazy.
Yeah, you guys are fucked up. What the hell?
I've never licked coal.
Never. A lot of people did eat Jack's beard hair, but that was a few years ago. We didn't know any better.
I remember that. There have been so many instances this week and, like, last week where someone has told me, you don't remember this happened? And I go... It's like an echo. Like, you are saying things that sound right. I just don't have a memory.
You said we call those repressed memories.
That makes sense.
There's a lot of those in Extra Life.
I ate Jack's beard hair. I forgot about that.
You I can't believe you forgot about that.
I almost did, but Barbara saved me.
I made a double down.
A double down.
I took two pieces of chicken hair. And I put beard hair between it, and I ate. I forgot about. Oh my god.
You forgot. I can't. You know what? It's okay. Do we want to think about something else right now? Is that okay?
That's okay.
So
let's try.
Hi guys, this episode of I Have Notes is sponsored by HBO Max. Do you like spooky movies fun for the whole family? HBO Max has you covered, especially on October 22nd when they release their new movie, The Witches, based off of the Roald Dahl book. It stars Anne Hathaway with Stanley Tucci together for the first time since The Devil Wears Prada, spooky, along with a team of world-class filmmakers, Robert Zemeckis, Alfonso Cuarón, Guillermo del Toro, and Kenya Barris coming together for a fun family event. And if that isn't your cup of tea, HBO Max has 10,000 hours of curated premium content with shows from the rest of the Warner Brothers catalog, along with some really awesome partners like DC, Adult Swim, Crunchyroll, Rooster Teeth, Looney Tunes, you name it. So make sure you go check out HBO Max. Thanks, guys. All right, so I have a question here, which was kind of like, what is something that made you happy in the last week?
Well, I was off work last week, so
plenty.
It was pretty chill for me. Yeah. Sleeping in, not answering questions. Trying to think of like a thing that made me happy last week.
I like the video that you sent.
That was this week.
Oh, all right, that was this week.
Something that made me happy this week is I got that Mario Kart thing where you can like Mario Kart Live where you can drive around. I've purchased it. I've received it. I haven't done a single race with it. Because all I do is just drive around and mess with my cat. And that's honestly the most fun part. I filmed this earlier today, actually.
Oh, my God.
Really thought he was going to be a lot more scared of it. And he's not. It says honk to continue, by the way, because you're supposed to continue setting up the game. And I haven't. And I just...
This is the farthest you've gotten.
Yeah. He's a little nervous right now. He's like, I don't know what this thing's doing.
He was a little nervous. I was surprised he didn't attack it and he didn't like run. It works pretty well on carpet. I'm honestly very surprised. This is also a sneak peek of my office, my home office.
Hello. It's
behind me right now. There he is.
Oh. And then you did you backed into the wall.
I booped. It's really clever having, you know, so the camera, that's the view you expect the camera to have. Just like the way the cart is set up, but then they just, you know, overlay that over. It really sells the immersion.
Yeah, for sure.
Like I genuinely like will be playing and forget that it's actually like a physical thing behind me.
You forget that you're in your room.
Yeah, until I see myself in the background, I'm like, oh shit.
That's so neat.
So that made me happy.
Yay.
There we go.
Cole, what made you happy?
You should have told me about this beforehand. I would have come up with something.
Sorry, guys.
That's the sign of 2020 that you've really got to think.
Think about things, but it's nothing unique to last week.
That doesn't matter.
Trying to kind of getting by. I think I actually started watching anime again last week, which I hadn't really done
a lot of since.
Yeah, this new season 2 weeks ago, but I was catching up on stuff last week.
Chad, have you heard of anime?
I think.
But, like, until, like, last week, I haven't really watched anything the majority of time in quarantine. So, it was nice to go and actually watch something for a change. To be like,
yeah, I've been in kind of an anime rut lately. What did you watch? I need something.
Everyone should watch Jujutsu Kaisen.
I've heard that intro is, like,
pitch
amazing.
Pitch it, go.
It is a story about exorcist hunting demons with a boy who is taking on the demon powers within himself to fight the demons.
Okay.
Wow.
Got it.
It sounds like a crossover between like Bleach
and D. Gray Man,
and the main character looks like Natsu from Fairy Tail because he has pink hair.
Nice.
A little bit, but not as. It's better.
It's not as Naisu.
Nice, not good way, good way, Kerry. I like that.
But no, it's asked some questions early on. I think the third episode came out Friday. So
okay.
It's I don't know what it is, like, because at this point now I feel bad because I'm like, okay, a new shonen jump show, it has to prove it to me. It has to prove it that it's gonna be good.
My Hero has My Hero set the bar.
Yeah.
My Hero
very
set
high.
The bar. But also, yeah, and I don't know why I think that, because all of those shows, normally the reason that they're getting made into shows is because they're kind of proven.
That's true. So, I mean, it's the value of that medium is that, you know, they essentially have a version of it out there and they go, this would be good animated as well. So, I mean, like, yeah.
Yeah.
And so I went into it, was like, we'll see how it is. And I'm like, it's really good. Why did I expect anything otherwise than it to be really good? So
no. For me, let's see. Last week, something that made me happy. This is just going to depress you all. You guys probably don't know this, but I've told this on a couple other things. So, sorry, audience, if you've heard this before. The super quick version is that my daughter's friend lives directly behind us, and they were so desperate for just like kid interaction during this pandemic that they literally busted a hole in the fence.
That's awesome.
So that's happened. That was like months and months and months ago.
I'm so glad you clarified, because when you just said she lives behind your house, I was like, what kind of?
No, it's like their house. I got that fence, right? Yeah. So they busted this hole in this fence. Like one day, literally, their three children came running into my house, and I was like, wait a minute, that's not the right number. I have two. And they were just like, we did it! Like, and I'm just like, what's happening? So now we've like agreed to just be like, you know, like we're just gonna quarantine together. So like, you know, their son will come over and hang out with us for a little while. But both the kids went over last week to our neighbor's house, and April and I both had this moment where we just sat in complete silence, and we both just like poured a drink, and we were just like, this is fucking amazing. And
The first actual piece of quiet you've gotten in 7 months.
Yeah, right.
Aww.
Like, I like to think that you both put on noise canceling headphones, but then just sat in the room together and just like.
Let's see. It's like we didn't even talk. That was like,
y'all can talk later.
I thought, like, at first I was like, oh, they probably went to the hot tub, but I was like, no, like it's probably even better to not just like no external stimulus, just.
And you can't do the hot tub in the middle of the day during when it's like, you know, Texas heat, right?
That's true. That's true.
Man, we're almost there.
That's just called the tub.
People, yeah.
At that point, everything is kind of the same level.
I'm so excited. I am very excited. It's about to get cold out, and there's nothing better than it's like cold outside, and you're in the hot tub, and it's the best. Man, best purchase ever.
Okay, good.
I guess I'm kind of thinking in my head, like, well, okay, hot tub and cold weather. That sounds great. But do you ever want to leave?
Oh, no, that sucks.
Okay. Yeah.
Getting out is the worst. You know, you just got to go quick.
Okay.
See,
okay.
For me, that's what wakes me up enough to get back to the house. It like, because I'm in the hot tub, I'm about to fall asleep. And if I'm not careful, I'm going to fall asleep in there. Yeah. So if I get out of it, it wakes me up enough to get to my bed. And then I'm like, okay, yep, that's my body has had a shock. The extremes of both temperatures. I'm ready to sleep.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Let's get some light hypothermia.
Just a little bit of hypo.
Just a touch.
Just kiss it a little bit.
It's to get you the energy. Sometimes you need those extremes.
I'm glad you had that quiet moment, Chad.
Thank you.
Issa, did you tell us? You didn't tell us your happy moment.
You told us. What's your happy moment?
That's a good question. I think I'm
It's your question.
I know.
Yeah,
right?
You put it on us.
I typed it and then I didn't come up with an answer. This happens very often. I just want other people to have answers for me.
That's your happy moment.
Yeah, that's my happy moment. Everyone else's answer.
Not having to answer this question.
that's a tough one. Well, it's not that nothing terrible is happening to me right now. I'm just going through a phase. I think last week it was enough where, like, at night, I kind of was, like, pouring a drink, and my partner was like, oh, it's drink time? And I went, it's drink time.
It's always drink time now.
It's always 5 o'clock somewhere, as they say.
We watched.
I thought of another one.
Oh, you thought of another one?
You go ahead.
The last episode of Haikyuu was actually good. The context is that the week prior, everyone was really off model.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it was kind of.
Is it?
Go ahead.
Oh, go on. No, is it not Who's animating it?
It's IG. I think it's production IG. So the thing is with Haikyuu, the volleyball anime, is it's very consistent in terms of like whether or not things are actually off model or not. So it's a lot of people say it's a good anime, and for me, it genuinely is, not just for the story and the characters, but on a quality level as well. I think it's very like either good, okay, but it's never been bad. And this was like the first episode. It was kind of clear. My partner and I were talking about it. We were like, oh, is it because of the pandemic? Because it's clear they really had to outsource this one. And it was so off model. We were like, it has never been that bad before. So that was really interesting. But then the episode after makes a lot of sense because it was a concentration on one of the best boys of the show. And it was very good. And it kind of went back to that normal like volleyball anime energy where we're like, yeah, just screaming at the end. It was pretty good.
It probably is that it was like, because the last season was in January.
Yeah, it was like a half.
January to April. Mm-hmm. And so like, there's got to be some bleed over into quarantine times of them working on the new season.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
I'm most curious because, like, I know, I obviously not like everybody, but there are a lot of like animators in the industry that do just work from home, anyways.
Yeah,
that's true.
So I was curious how much it was going to affect it.
True, but I mean, it's not only the animators; it's
producers.
And audio departments and all the stuff that, like, I can almost guarantee that audio departments do not have home setups.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Like, it's
that's why I was just more thinking because if the characters are like off model, like it was maybe what more focused on the animation area. But
true.
Yeah. No, I get that. Yeah, I mean, it's I certainly do for other mediums, and I hope people will do for ours. Like, it's hard to make content in a room by yourself. And things are going a little bit slower here and there. So I think we're all going to look back at 2020 as a little rough around the edges here and there.
Well,
it's media and life.
And life.
It's interesting because I was trying to figure a way if we could bring it up here. I can't remember who interviewed somebody. There was some anime news network not the anime news network, but some kind of anime news outlet that interviewed some creator who's doing a lot of stuff with Netflix, and they were kind of asking how Netflix has changed the landscape of animation. And this person's insight was kind of before that. Ultimately, what affected whether a new season of anime was going to get made was whether they were going to get the money from China. Whether the ratings were good enough, whether the sales were good enough, and if they weren't, then they probably weren't going to get a new season. But they're saying now Netflix doesn't necessarily care about high ratings. They want to just fill out their catalog. So a lot of times shows that wouldn't have gotten a second season might have more of an opportunity. And this might be their personal experience, but I thought that was interesting. Especially
Disney Plus, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, well, I mean, might as well have something. Just fill out, like, people are paying for this because they want a huge catalog of a bunch of anime. And whether it's like the best thing ever or not, it's there.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, and there's something to be said, too. It's like, you know, what... Just because it has bad ratings doesn't mean that it's bad, too. So maybe the show just got slept on, or was going up against like another big show, you know, or you know, just like I've got to imagine it can be really difficult to, like, you know, bring these stories to life, especially when they're like more different series. Mm-hmm. So it's like, you know, I'm sure some of them are a little hit or miss in the first season. I think I know for y'all, but for me, it's always like, if I'm gonna watch a show, I watch the first three episodes.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, because you gotta give them a few, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. That's like the thing. It's like the three episode rule. I can tell you that there are some shows that I watch the first episode and I like it. I dislike it so much that I'm like, I'm not gonna give. Like, if you're trying to watch a lot, you're not gonna have the time to watch the first three episodes of everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's where I then have to go off of, like, I'll go to Cole or Issa or
does
Chad.
This get better?
Yeah.
Does this
and get be like, out? Yeah. Is this worth it? Please tell me.
And then there's, I mean, like, then there's shows like Steins Gate, which I think is good all the way through, but it's like constantly considered one of the best anime of all time, and it doesn't really pick up until episode 12.
Right.
And then it recontextualizes everything you've seen before, but, like, I was watching with my friend, and he was like, oh, okay. And then episode 12, he's like, oh, okay. Oh, I'm interested now. Like,
A banana in a microwave?
But getting that far into it is kind of like, you kind of have to, the 12, the three episode rule sometimes doesn't always work. And the other thing is now creators are aware of the 3-episode rule.
Oh, yeah.
So what they'll do is they'll pack the first 3 episodes with a lot of intensity and craziness.
But it's
and then
reflective.
The 4th episode, there might be a huge drop off because they're normally going to finish the initial volume's arc by episode 3. And then it's going to kind of go, okay, well, we need some filler because we can't just have action the entire time. I know there's the joke that every episode 7 is always the beach or hot spring episode because they want to, that's like the mid-season mark. You want to hit them with the most fan service you can.
Yeah.
To keep them around. But yeah, it's interesting how watching habits.
Speaking of new shows, I got tagged like crazy because Cole, you probably heard of it. Have you heard about Skate Infinity?
Yeah, you actually told me about it.
Oh, that's right.
Death Battle. Yeah.
Yep. Man,
skateboarding?
It's a skateboard anime, and the main character has red hair.
Oh.
And so like a bunch of people were tagging me, and I was like, listen, I don't know what studio is picking this up, but let me voice that character. This is what I was born for.
Can you give me your best skater lingo? Like, let's say you just landed.
Carrie, I literally don't have to change a thing. This is exactly right here.
You just landed a sick Christ air.
Christ.
It's Skate the Infinity.
Yes, Skate the Infinity.
So it's Aniplex of America is publishing, so it means it's probably gonna have a chance to run through Funimation.
Cole?
Yes!
I need to find out what Chad is gonna say after he lands his Christ air.
Did you see me shred that gnar, brah?
Oh my god.
Cast.
Also, to throw something out there for Issa, it's going to be, I think, the director of Free is directing it.
Oh, really?
Interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
Director of Free and writing is Code Geass writer. What?
I'm like looking
it's
it up
the
now.
Code Geass writer for All series right. composition.
Hell yeah.
Oh, it's animated by
Gundam Iron Blood and Orphan character designs. What the hell? What's going on here? This is
It's apparently like an all-star team
stacked.
That's oh, doing
wow.
this.
This really is stacked. Wow. I'm
Whoa,
impressed.
That looks rad.
Just watching it now. Chat.
Right,
we'll,
on social
we'll,
media.
We will at campaign. Funny and also at you at the same time.
Yeah.
We used to do double talk. I know people at Funimation.
It's true.
I'm gonna lean on everything.
Yeah.
It's true.
Like, hey, remember everything we did? Remember all the good times?
Yeah.
All the good times.
Hashtag skater Chad.
Skater
hashtag.
Sure.
I'm that's it.
Hashtag it's okay. Chad the Infinity.
Chad the Infinity.
There
it
is.
That's your new
See, what you enough. Witnessed was in that moment of silence I had, I fell asleep for 1 second, a full second. I fell asleep in my head. And now I'm groggy.
Oh, no.
I don't know what to say.
I do have actually a question for you, Chad. Since you have 2 kids, have you had to watch a lot of kid programming during this entire...
Oh, my God.
I'm so sorry.
Did you get bullied into buying Mulan?
So it's buying what?
Mulan?
No.
From Disney. Oh, okay.
Okay, good.
We have not, because we heard it was terrible.
Nice.
And good. Anyway.
Glad your kids have taste.
So, first of all, my daughter is in a phase where she only wants to watch live action shows.
Ooh. Boo! Boo!
Oh, I know.
I have
And
notes.
It's like...
I have no.
She's just all about it, and like, she's... Like, she loves it, and she's just like, you know, there. At first it was like, cartoons are for kids. And I'm like, okay. No, they're not.
You forget, your dad makes cartoons.
That's how dad makes some of his money. And so, she's just, I don't know, she's all about it. She just loves live action shows. Like, all of those, like, Disney, like, wacky kid shows. Like, she just eats it.
Oh, okay. Like, Ant Farm. And
oh,
like,
yeah. All of that. She loved School of Rock. She's now currently into Hannah Montana. We'll see how that goes.
And just,
be like, hey, don't look
Even
up
Stevens.
What happened to her.
Okay.
But like every now and then I could sneak one in. Like she was into She-Ra for a little bit. And we were like,
okay.
It's like, but like. Yeah,
Avatar?
Know, she's just all about it. So that's all she wants to watch. My son, who is 3, just like obsesses about like, a couple movies, and then he just needs to watch them. I'm not kidding you when I say in the past week, We have probably watched Nightmare Before Christmas 40 times and Hocus Pocus probably like 30.
Wow. Aww. At least he's seasonal. At least it's the accurate season. Oh, like he's not watching
all about Halloween right now.
Like, please tell me you have a Switch.
I do.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
It's the only thing to save you from this. Okay, perfect. Okay, good. Okay, good. Wow.
Yeah. Oh my God.
That's what I did when I was a kid.
All the things. The thing that kills me, and like Disney, I know you're watching this.
they're required to.
They released all of the like old short cartoons, you know, that were like thematically like the Donald Duck cartoon and like, you know, all this stuff. They're all individual and they're short. They're like 10 minutes ish, maybe 15.
Oh no.
And they don't lead into anything else. So you can't just be like, play, this will entertain you for like an hour while I go work.
Oh.
It will stop in 10 to 15 minutes. And then he's just busting back into the room and being like, my Pocus, show, Pocus. Daddy. And I'm just like, God, I hate these things. But he loves them. And he wants to watch them, or he wants to watch them over and over again. I'm just like, put that shit in a playlist. Please. Please put that. For all parents stuck at home in a pandemic, put it in a playlist so that I can leave him the fuck alone and get something done.
Save Chad.
Change it. Save Chad, add a playlist.
By the way, I love my children. It's a, there's a million positive stories I can tell, but the crazy ones
I
are
don't.
More...
Whoa!
You don't love my children?
Well, they, your
That's
daughter
probably
doesn't like,
good, actually.
Your daughter doesn't like anime.
Not yet.
Bring it, try, po, put her on camera, and let me call her stupid.
I'm not gonna... I'll go get her.
No, 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 I don't want. I don't want to actually.
Come on, Gary.
I'm sure
calling you out,
nice.
Gary.
No, I'm a chicken. I don't
we have a stretch goal for
Dude,
Extra Life now.
She'll probably get right back.
I'm gonna berate your child
really
for
into,
Extra Life.
I don't know what the anime it was that got very Americanized to Glitter Force. Cole, do you know what that is?
Oh.
Precure. There it is. Precure. So she got like super into that, and she watched all of that like probably two times over.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, we'll get there. And she
that's
does
a pretty good. That's a pretty good one. That's a pretty good for like
Precure's
magical role.
Yeah.
She likes some Ghibli movies. She got she wanted to watch Princess Mononoke, and I was a little bit on the fence.
How old is she?
She's 8. And so
I
was like a little bit on the fence because there's a lot of blood in that. And like
I
told her and she's like, no, I'm fine, blah, blah, blah. And, but like she couldn't
that
get
could
past
easily
the,
go either
the
way.
Writhing infected boar, you know, and like then she was just like, I don't want to watch this. Like,
It could be a little scary. It could be a little scary.
But she loves Kiki's Delivery Service. And fun fact, one of the reasons
Who
that
doesn't?
We settled, that's one of April and I's favorite Ghibli movies.
Aww.
And one of the reasons we settled on the name of Kira was because we could call her Kiki for short as her nickname. So,
that's okay, like, I don't hate her anymore. That's cute.
That would be like the most adorable conversation where you're like, oh, if it's Kira, we can call her Kiki.
Yeah.
High fives.
No, that
Everyone
is that was
fives.
The final straw. Like, we're like, well, we really like that name. And like, that's, you know, there's, I don't know. There's a lot of similar names, right? You know, that you hear, and it's just like, oh, I don't really hear that name a lot. And it's like, that'd be cool. But that was the final straw. We're just like, I think April was like, we could call her Kiki. We're like, oh, sweet.
Done. Signed.
Kira,
when you're playing
Kira
the movie,
wants to get a black cat and name it Gigi.
Gigi.
So.
When you're playing the movie, did you just point at the screen and be like, that's your namesake?
We did tell her. That's you know, we told her, like, hey, this is one of the reasons like we settled on your name.
Oh.
Right now she's in a phase where she wants to be called Victoria.
Oh.
Children. And I'm just like,
Which television series is Victoria from?
Victoria?
Yeah, she just for some reason loves that name. It wasn't from any show or anything. She just like thinks it's just like a fanciful magic name and she really likes it. And I'm just like, sweetheart, I love you. And you know
I
what?
Can go ahead.
If you want to change your name when you get older. You know, you can. I'll probably be a little sad, but I will be supportive of you.
Oh.
In the meantime, I'm going to call you the name that I gave you.
In this house? Someone,
in this house.
As someone who also wanted to change their name growing up.
Oh, that's
I first wanted to name myself Pepper because of Lego Island.
Yes!
I wanted to change my name to Kaiba at one point because of, obviously, Yu-Gi-Oh!
Kaiba?
Yep.
Lego Island, dude.
Are you doing the right call.
The 1997 like Lego Island PC game.
Yes.
Yep.
Were you delivering his pizza
game.
Delivery boy?
Were you delivering pizzas on a skateboard?
Pepper was
love
awesome. Oh God, man, you just took me back. Yeah. Well, I hear you. I mean, so like the problem is like we're all you guys. All your names are great. right? Whereas like when I was a kid, I was like, I remember I really wanted the name. I want to be named Jason. Like I thought that would be great.
Jason.
All right.
But everybody goes through all that stuff. There's probably some cool kid in the neighborhood that I thought, you know, whatever. And I was like, yeah, I named Jason. The problem is, none of you guys are named Chad. That name fucking sucks.
Yeah.
It's the worst. Like, and it's memed all the time. There will be comments on this video that say, oh, Chad being such a Chad, every fucking thing that I'm in. You can't escape it. And it's
Chad.
Every like decade, there's a new meme about it. There was the Charlie's Angels movie came out and Tom Green played a character called the Chad. So then Chad, I had to deal with everybody's like, the Chad is great, blah, 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 blah. Deal with that forever. Then that like Chad Bro Chill internet video came out and everybody that. And now it's like the like whole just like such a Chad, virgin Chad,
the virgin walk, the Chad
too.
Walk. Oh. Yeah.
Hanging
it,
Chad.
There's something about this name that just every, it just inspires hate. Resentment. And like it will continue and I can't escape it and it sucks.
Do you want me to solve your problem?
Chad, okay.
What
do you mean solve your problem? Like I can fix your problem right now. You got two problems, I got one solution. You change your name to Kiki.
To what?
Oh.
To Kiki. Or Kira.
I thought you changed your name to Victoria. And then
no.
That's dad's name and she is a wonder anymore.
So, yep. Oh, that's a power play, Cole. That is a power play.
If you change it to Kiki or Kira, she's gonna be like, but wait, that's cool. That's my name. I want that.
No, she would rebel.
Oh, okay, never mind. She'd make it Victoria then.
As someone who was also named after their dad, that wasn't the direction I was going.
Okay, it's you make like, your first name Victor. And then she's like, okay, it's not the same, but fine. But then you change your middle name.
To Oria.
Yeah,
I follow you. I was right there with you, Carrie.
Yeah, you drop that on her 2 seconds later, and she's like, what? No.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so funny.
I remembered another one. Lloyd from Legend of the Dragoon. Yep, that was another one.
Oh,
that's really Chad, I think I know the answer
that I
to
don't
this.
Feel holds up, Lloyd, in today.
No, I'm like, I'm so glad I was not allowed to change my name.
Lloyd's the kind of guy that tries to sell you shit from an alley. Like that's.
Yep.
Mm. Yeah, I don't think you're not allowed to be named Lloyd under 30.
The fact that I ever wanted to have two L's as the first letters of my name.
Yeah.
No.
Call you Lloyd.
Chad, I think I know the answer to this, but what is worse? Having Chad as your first name or having two first names?
I have three, dude.
He does. Yes, I remember this.
My middle name is Paul.
Wow.
So, honestly, that doesn't screw
you got to start
so
rocking the CPJ, the Chad Paul James.
Oh, don't get me started. I mean, like, Sam has referred to me as Chad James, like, forever.
It's true.
Yeah.
He does. Even when you're not around, he will be talking in backwards compatible. He'll be like, oh, yeah, Chad James.
Hey, Chad James.
I would meet people. It was like him and our friend Manoj growing up. And like, I would meet people for the first fucking time and be like, oh, yeah, hey, nice to meet you. My name's Chad. And they're like, Chad James? And I'm like, fucking hell. Like, how did this already,
God,
like,
that's so funny.
Get around?
It sounds to me like you've got somebody on your side on marketing.
Yeah.
Because you know why? To them, your name's not Chad anymore. Your name's Chad James.
That's a brand.
Nobody's making Chad James jokes.
Yeah.
They're making Chad jokes.
There you go. I like that. Just lean forward.
Sam's got your fucking back.
I will say that. The one benefit is whenever I'm like out of state and have to show my ID for whatever reason, it's hilarious because you know different states do the naming convention differently on a license.
Oh my god!
Right.
Yeah.
And so like literally, they're like, okay, I just need to see some ID, Mr.
Chat.
They have this moment.
Which one do I pick?
All of these could be first names.
Oh, that's like, so funny!
Oh my god. Your business card in Japan would be James Chad Paul.
James yep. Chad Paul.
I'm only gonna refer to you as Chad Paul James from now on.
Chad Paul James. That's pretty good. It's rhythmic. Let's put it that way.
Yeah.
That's a song, Chad Paul James.
Yes, I mean the evolution of it was it started as just Sam calling me Chad James like everywhere,
that's true.
And then it became Chad motherfucking James, which he did all the time, which he loved to do.
Yeah,
I'm in his phone as CMFJ, just so you know.
Yeah, I'm in there as Cole Bloodboy Galleon. So.
Yeah. Cole's got like monogram towels.
God,
it's great.
I should have seen that coming, but I saw him. Yeah, that's the second time
I saw it. I was like,
out.
This is too perfect. This is too perfect.
Strike. Was that also two things? Was that orange juice? And then follow up, can you carbonate orange juice?
It's not orange soda. Not or,
no, this is this is
okay. Is the way the light hit it.
Jameson and 7-Up.
Oh, it's drink time.
Oh, nice.
It's drink time, Issa.
It's drink time.
It's always drink time.
And it's already carbonated, but orange juice, you could probably I'm sure they do. Like, that's basically
mimosas.
What mimosa is, right? Yeah, see, Cole, you know what's up.
Yeah.
Oh.
Also, guys, apparently I've inspired Noelle to dig into this further because at 5:30, so 30 minutes ago-ish,
I like this
said, your response has been noted, and he just said, LOL. But then now, just now, he followed up with, all caps, wait, if it's like this, I'm okay with it. This is a yogurt type of drink, and I've been drinking it my whole life.
Is this talking about
your cult? Yes, wait, exactly. No, that's the thing that Aaron drinks.
He linked me a cult. But I just love that it's 30 minutes has passed, and this is weight on this man. Like, he had to go do some research.
His fingers have been active on that keyboard.
That's Issa, that's the drink that Aaron would always get.
Yakult, yeah.
At Asahi.
Yes.
Huh.
The right? Calico or the...
Calpico.
Calpico, yeah.
Oh, is that carbonated?
I think
so. I don't know if it was milk, though.
ColecoVision?
Calico Cats? Because I thought Calpico was like some kind of like carbonated sweat drink. Like how it
carbonated
was,
soft drink. It's a... Yeah, okay.
Okay.
You said sweat drink.
Well, there's a drink in Japan called Pocari Sweat.
But it is made with it is made with yogurt.
Oh, what?
Huh.
It's like mango, somewhat milky. The beverage is light, somewhat milky, light acidic flavor, similar to plain or vanilla yogurt or Yakult.
I thought Cole was spouting that off the dome for a moment, and I was like, why did he have that much information about it?
He has a tattoo in the back of his hand that he likes to consult.
Right here.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, man, everywhere you go, Pocari Sweat in Japan, and then like Boss Coffee with...
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God. Why am I blanking on his name?
K.
Oh.
Yeah, K from...
Tommy Lee Jones.
Yeah, it's Tommy Lee Jones.
Oh, I've seen that drink before.
And then they had the Boss Dog. Do you remember that? And like,
Blaine drank too much Boss Coffee the last time we were in Japan. He got addicted to that and then to chai tea, and he was stuck in the bathroom every morning.
Hey, at least he's regular.
I was going to say, I was like, oh, well, you know, that's probably okay.
Yeah.
I want to go to Japan, guys.
I want
to
go.
Me too.
I want to be allowed to go.
I'm trying as hard as possible. We're trying as hard as possible.
Yeah. We'll see. Hopefully,
when the pandemic's over, can we all go? Let's all plan a trip.
That'd be fun.
Hopefully,
let's do it
next March-ish.
Oh,
we'll
yeah.
Be okay.
Last I saw was April. They'd be allowing people in. Hopefully,
it's my birthday.
Chad has some hope.
Hope. Hope.
It's not
happy
all
birthday,
gone
Chad.
Yet.
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
We'll see.
We'll see. And speaking of we'll see, we should conclude our episode.
We'll see
I was
later.
Like, okay.
We'll see you
next episode.
We'll be continued.
We'll
you
see
next time.
You next time. Yeah, same brain, Carrie. Same brain.
Please share. I'm back. You can tell everybody I'm back. Please share the show with your friends.
Whoopin,
watch it.
He's back.
Watch it on First. We appreciate it. And stay tuned for more Extra Life news. We're very excited about that.
Yeah.
Chad's going to announce all of the things he's going to be writing and condiments on himself.
Where is the best place to find Extra Life news, Chad? I legitimately want to know as well.
So right now we've kind of just been talking about it on like various podcasts.
Okay.
Following Rooster Teeth social media, we'll have some stuff out as soon as we have like the schedule locked down and where to do that. Mm-hmm. And then pretty soon we'll be updating our usual landing page, which I don't have on hand because it was
make sure so basically just make sure you're listening and watching every Rooster Teeth podcast.
Yeah, watch every video that we make.
Yeah.
And follow at Rooster Teeth on Twitter and social media and that stuff.
I'm pretty sure live stream up. Like yours, Katie's, and Jack's socials are probably gonna be ablaze whenever.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Happen. So
awesome. Cool. Awesome.
Thanks, Cole. Thanks, Chad.
Yeah, thanks for having me on.
Thanks for having
thanks.
Us.
Thanks.
And bye. Thank you, Carrie. Bye.